Beloved in Christ, in this Christmas tide, let it be our care and delight to hear again the message of the angels, and in heart and mind to go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass and the babe lying in a manger. Let us read and mark in Holy Scripture the tale of the loving purposes of God from the first day of our disobedience unto the glorious redemption brought to us by this holy child, and let us make this place tonight glad with our carols of praise. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace and goodwill over all the earth, for the mission and unity of the church for which Christ died, and especially in this country and within our city of Richmond. And because this of all things would rejoice his heart, let us at this time remember in his name the poor and the helpless, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and little children, and all those who know not the Lord Jesus, or who love him not, or who by sin have grieved his heart of love. Lastly, let us remember before God his pure and lowly mother, and all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and with whom in this our Lord Jesus we forevermore are one. These prayers and praises let us humbly offer up to the throne of heaven in the words which Christ himself hath taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, you have given us a new revelation of your living providence in the coming of your Son, Jesus Christ, to be born of the Virgin Mary. Grant that as he shared our mortality, so we may share with his eternity in the glory of your kingdom, where he lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us.
And we beheld his glory.
The glory of the Lord has been revealed.
And all flesh shall see the salvation of our God.
O God, you make us glad by the yearly festival of the birth of your only Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that we who joyfully receive him as our Redeemer may with sure confidence behold him when he comes to be our Judge, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
In the day of Ahaz, son of Jotham, son of Uzziah, king of Judah, King Rezin of Aram, and King Pekah, son of Remaliah of Israel, went up to attack Jerusalem, but could not mount an attack against it. When the house of David heard that Aram had aligned itself with Ephraim, the heart of Ahaz and the heart of its people shook, as the trees of the forest shake before the wind. Then the Lord said to Isaiah, "Go out to meet Ahaz, you and your son Shear-Joshim, at the end of the conduit of the upper pool on the highway to Fuller's Field, and say to him, 'Take heed, be quiet, do not fear, and do not let your heart be faint, because of those two smoldering stumps of firebrands, because of the fierce anger of Rezin and Aram, and the son of Remaliah, because Aram with Ephraim and the son of Remaliah has plotted evil against you, saying, "Let us go up against Judah and cut off Jerusalem and conquer it for ourselves and make the son of Tebal king of it." Therefore, thus says the Lord God, "It shall not stand and it shall not come to pass. Ask a sign of the Lord your God. Let it be as deep as Sheol or as high as heaven." Then Isaiah said,
"Hear then, O house of David, is it too little for you to weary mortals, that you weary my God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with child and shall bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel. He shall eat curds and honey by the time he knows how to refuse the evil and choose the good. For before the child knows how to refuse the evil and choose the good, the land before whose two kings you are in dread will be deserted. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this."
Thank you. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee, called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said,
"Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you."
But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will receive the Holy Spirit, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will bring him from the Spirit of the Holy Spirit. He will reign over the house of David forever, and of his kingdom will be done. The Holy Spirit will come from high, and the power of the Most High will overshadow. Therefore,
she said.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying,
Jesus is born.
when the angels had left them and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, so they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child. And he was called Jesus, a name given by the angel before he was conceived in the womb.
In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking,
"Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews?
We have seen his star in the east. We have come to worship him."
When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him, and calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them, "Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying,
'Go and search for the child.'
When they had heard the king, they set out, and there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy."
Thank you.
And when they came into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life as the light of all the people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. John came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself is not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, but of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. The Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of the God's only Son, full of grace and truth. From his fullness we have all received grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God, the only Son, who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known.
Thank you.
And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men.
Wow. Before going further, let's just thank all the children and youth who just did a wonderful job tonight with our Christmas pageant. A special shout out to Paulette Pullen, who is our pageant director, who organized all this chaos so well tonight. And if you bump into her after she's probably taken several naps, just thank her for all that she did. Mark and Virginia Whitmire and the Cherub and Children and Youth Choirs as well. My thanks as well to all of our volunteers who helped tonight. And as you can see, you don't get the baby Jesus born without a lot of help. So thanks to all of them. And a special thanks as well to Becky Page, our Director of Children's Ministries here at St. James. This evening I'll commend to you our upcoming Christmas Eve schedule of services. Just look in the back of your bulletin to see all the different times. But I invite you to sort of, as this sort of begins our observance of the Christmas season, I invite you to come and take part in all of those services as well to celebrate the birth of our Savior. Walk in love as Christ loved us, gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God. Let us pray. O Lord, support us all the day long, until shadows lengthen and the evening comes, when the weary world is hushed, and the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in thy mercy grant us a safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at the last. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
May Christ, who by his incarnation gathered into one thing all things earth and heavenly, fill you with his joy and his peace, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, remain with you, now and always. Amen.
Amen.